the long history is the young man's name up there, Jim Steinman, had the idea of doing a musical in college when he was in Amherst. And the name of the play back then was Dream Engine. Now, he got Joe Papp, who was the biggest producer in New York, and maybe the biggest producer ever. I don't know in the early 30s or 40s if there was a bigger producer. All I know is the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, until he passed away in like 2007. He was the biggest producer on Broadway, from Lincoln Center to the Public Theater, New York Shakespeare Festival, Chorus Line, on and on, just endless. And so he went to see the play, Dream Engine, and put Steinman on salary at the Public Theater when Jim graduated. And I went to New York to do hair in 69, about the time Jim was doing his play. And 2 years later, I got an agent, and he said, if you want to work, if you want to be a working actor in New York, you have to work for Joe Papp. So I went down, auditioned for Steinman. He said, wait here, brought in 40 people. I sing about four notes. Joe Papp handed me a script, and in the script was one song, which wasn't in the script, but was added, which was Steinman. And it was the first time I ever got a standing ovation for anything, and the first time that any Jim Steinman song had got that kind of reaction. And so that's kind of how we got together. And then Lou Adler, who was the producer of the Rocky Horror Show, Jim came out to the opening, and Lou Adler said, if you two don't work together, then you're out of your minds. And we did, and Bat Out of Hell came about. But this has been a 50-year dream for Jim Steinman. Now, can you imagine having a dream for 50 years finally come true? How you must feel. It must not feel real to him, and it makes me cry, because he is my friend, and I love him so much that to sit here and see this is unbelievable. Jim Steinman has never told me what he's written about. I sang everything in character on every record. Every song is in character. I will never tell anybody what the character is. Jimmy has never asked me what the character is. The only things that Jim has ever said was, the melody's wrong, or I've heard you do it better. Or we will discuss. I won't go in and tell him what my character is. I will go in and say, if you wrote this kind of lyric here, it would work better for my character. And he always does. And basically, we're, as human beings, he's night, I'm day. Artistically, we are one person.
If the musical is a huge success on stage, would you have any interest in seeing it transfer to cinema?
Oh, I have no idea. You can never tell that. That's like predicting the future. We might as well go down to the psychic down the street and give her $100 and find out what she's got to say about it. The main thing they have to do first is make sure the cast is right, make sure the production is right, and make sure that everything is in place for it to work for the public.